with Two Tone at the time, the ska revival, I always found that there was a closer connection with punk than there was with ska. It was like a lot of what would normally be a punk band would get up there and play an offbeat, and suddenly you've got something that sounds vaguely like ska.
None of us was really interested in being part of what was effectively just a ska revival. To start playing ska was like taking two steps backwards, you know what I mean? So we wanted something a little bit more long-lasting.
The band that would take 70s reggae into the pop charts for the next 30 years was a bunch of Birmingham lads.
We called ourselves a jazz dub reggae band when we started. But we wanted to make reggae music, you know, that was important to us. It wasn't going to be Jamaican reggae, you know, because we were a British band and we wanted to make British reggae, like a hybrid. Our environment totally shaped who we were. I think if you went to Balsall Heath, which is where most of us grew up, and grabbed eight guys off the street, they'd look pretty much like us. They'd be the same kind of racial mix. We were immediately more attractive, I think, to a British audience because we were mixed.
And as far as our image goes, we had no image. I'm like, you know, we just wear what we wore anyway, you know what I mean? We went into dressing up in uniforms and suits and whatever, you know what I mean? Yeah, what you see is what you get.
We were called UB40 because we were all signing on at the time. A friend of ours suggested the name when we were trying to think of a name. And he said, you've all got UB40 cards. Why don't you call yourself UB40? So...
But it was honest as well, because we really did, you know, come from that, you know, without being able to take doll money, we'd never have been able to afford to rehearse for a start. We'd have had to get a job, you know, so we were actually in the middle of that. So it wasn't something that we took from the outside just hoping that we might attract an audience, you know. It was something, we were responding to the circumstances we were in.
So obviously when we made our first album, it was just a natural progression to call it Signing Off. Because we weren't signing on anymore, you know. It was a facsimile of the UB40 card.
It was pretty clever because it gave us, you know, 3 million card-carrying fans instantly. It sold 8 million copies, you know, and for an album made in a bedsuit, that was pretty good going.
To us, reggae didn't represent palm trees and beaches, you know, it represented the inner city. You know, that's when I heard reggae music, that's the image that I picture in my own head.